Chapter 9. Marvin got to school early and waited. Judy Jasper was dropped off in the school parking lot. Marvin watched her get out of her car. Marvin was glad she was alone. The kids usually weren't mean to him when they were alone. It was only when they were in a group. The bigger the group, the meaner they acted. "Judy," he called. "What?" asked Judy. She had very curly hair. "I have to ask you my survey question," said Marvin. "Okay," said Judy. "You have to tell the truth," said Marvin. "I will," said Judy. "Okay," said Marvin. "Well, here goes." He took a deep breath. "Have you ever picked your nose?" Judy screamed, then ran away. Marvin ran after her. "Wait," he called. "You have to answer my question." He chased her around the bike rack and caught up with her just outside the girls' bathroom. "Have you ever picked your nose?" he asked again. "Ever?" asked Judy. Marvin nodded. Judy ducked into the girls' bathroom. Marvin was about to walk away. But then, safe within the bathroom walls, Judy Jasper shouted, "Yes!" Kenny was drinking from the water fountain. "I have to ask you my question for the class survey," said Marvin. Kenny kept drinking. "Have you ever picked your nose?" asked Marvin. Kenny coughed and spit out water. He looked up at Marvin. "That's your question?" he asked. Marvin nodded. Did Mrs. North approve it?" Marvin shrugged. "Darn," said Kenny. "I didn't know you could ask questions like that." "So have you?" asked Marvin. "Yeah, I guess," said Kenny. Marvin wrote down Kenny's answer. "I'm going to see if it's too late to change my question," said Kenny. "I could ask all the girls, what color is your underwear?" He cracked up. Nick and Stuart arrived together. "What do you want?" asked Nick. "Don't worry," said Marvin. "I'm not going to try to be your friend. I just have to ask you my question for the class survey." "Okay," said Stuart. "But make it quick." He looked around to make sure that no one was watching. "Have you ever picked your nose?" asked Marvin. "Give me a break," said Stuart. "Just answer the question," said Marvin. "No one's ever going to like you if you keep asking questions like that," said Nick. "Just answer the question." "Yes, I've picked my nose," said Stuart. "Are you happy?" "Me too," said Nick, "but I don't go around talking about it." "What do you want, Snotface?" asked Clarence. "I have to ask you my survey question." "Just don't get any of your boogers on me," said Clarence. Marvin looked at him. He couldn't understand Clarence. They both knew that Clarence made that up. They both knew the ball was over the line. "No one else is around," said Marvin. "Can't we just be honest with each other?" "Booger brain," said Clarence. "Well, here's my question," said Marvin, "and you have to tell the truth." "I never lie," said Clarence. "Have you ever picked your nose?" "No way," said Clarence. "I'm not gross like you." Casey's ponytail stuck out the side of her head. "Casey," said Marvin, "I have to ask you my question for the class survey." "Shoot," said Casey. "Have you ever picked your nose?" Casey laughed. "Well, have you?" asked Marvin. She laughed so hard she fell to the ground. Marvin waited patiently. At last, Casey stopped laughing. She took a deep breath. "What was your question?" "Have you ever picked your nose?" asked Marvin. She laughed again. But between her hoots and howls, she managed to shriek, "Yes!" Justin said, "You're sickening, Marvin." "I'm not going to answer that question." "You have to," said Marvin. "It's for the survey." Justin turned and walked away. Marvin grabbed his shoulder. "You have to answer the question." "Not that question," said Justin, pushing Marvin away. "You have to," said Marvin, grabbing him again. "Justice, Marvin," shouted Mrs. Grant. Mrs. Grant was on yard duty. She sent the two boys to see Mr. McCabe, the principal, for fighting. A little while later, Marvin opened the door to his classroom. He peeked inside. Everyone else was still outside. "Mrs. North?" "Yes, Marvin," said his teacher, seated at her desk. "I want to ask you my question for the class survey." "Good for you, Marvin. I'm glad to see you're finally participating. Have you ever picked your nose?" Mrs. North sat up straight. "That's no way to talk to a teacher," she said. "It's for my survey," said Marvin. "Have you ever picked your nose?" "That is not a proper question," she said. "You need to choose something more appropriate." "Have you ever picked your nose?" Marvin repeated. "I'm serious, Marvin," said Mrs. North. "If you ask me that one more time, I'm going to send you straight to the principal's office." "I just came from there," said Marvin. "Mrs. Grant sent me for fighting with Justin." "There, see? And what did Mr. McCabe tell you?" "He told me he picked his nose." And that was chapter 9.